Today I'm going to be sharing one of my favorite seamless blonde looks. It's going to have a nice soft pop in the front and then diffusion throughout the rest. To achieve this, I'm going to be utilizing balayage and hair painting, but I'm going to be doing it in a combo. As you can see here along the part, I'm nicely creating a blend with my 3 points before going in and detailing those points. So I'm doing a little bit of hair painting in between, but not too much, and making sure that I leave depth. So it's almost creating these 3 little points. One tip I have is if you're working and you see something that doesn't look right, stop what you're doing and fix it as I just did. This will make your life so much easier. It's been about 8 months since she's been in, so I want to pop out her mid-lengths and ends. Her hair's super healthy because she'd maintained at home and kept with the at-home regimen that we had. Your hair being healthy is 20% of what I do and 80% of what you do at home. So always invest in good products that your stylist recommends. Now as I move closer to the front, I'm going to be doing a much heavier hair paint. I'm going to be hair painting at all angles. So if her hair were to move, she'd still have this really nice bright piece in the front. But since I'm hair painting it and it has that depth underneath the section I'm painting, it's going to look super soft and beautiful. It's really important when you're hair painting to really watch your saturation and make sure everything looks feathered and diffused. This will help from making it look like one really big, thick streak. Also, if when you're saturating on your paddle and you feel like it was too heavy, check the underside and diffuse. I use cotton underneath to protect against bleeds. I also use plastic to incubate the heat to help for processing and making sure that my product does not dry out. Now, as I start to do the hairline, I over-direct the hair up. This will allow to make sure I get those really, really nice ponytail pieces, so when she pulls her hair back, she'll still have that nice, soft, bright pop. I'm making sure everything's feathered and laying cotton once again. If you see something, do something about it. Just real quickly erase it with your cotton. Now I'm saturating through the mids and ends, laying my cotton down to protect against bleeds, and then popping out those mid-lengths and ends to really have that. And here's the end result, a soft, beautiful blonde. Thanks for watching. Go ahead and like and follow for more Life of a Painter.